Thank you once again, Master of Ceremony, Dr. Asha. Let me ask you once again another question, since this is my second session here. Does your club have a website? So far, we have seen a lot of social media workshops where connections are very important. You come across content based on somebody posting it in a group that you are part of or a friend that you are connected to. But people, when they have something that they want to do, you, for example, when you have something to do, you want to say how to make pasta. Where do you go when you want to answer that question? Everyone goes to Google to ask the fundamental questions in life. And that might include, how do I become a better speaker? How do I improve my public speaking skills? And generally, the search results will give you two things: a link to a YouTube video, which I covered earlier, or a website explaining how to go about doing what you want to do. For us as a club, why don't we have a website? Because when people want to search and they don't have any reference, they don't have a social connection, where will Google take them? If, for example, how to improve my public speaking skills in Kuwait, hopefully should land on your club website. And today I'm going to do in 20 minutes something that I have never done before. I'm going to show you how to create your club website from scratch. And you should be able to create, if you haven't already, a website for your club. No skills required. How cool is that? We are ready to create our own website for a club. In fact, I have kept everything ready. If something goes wrong technically, maybe the website went down, I have a backup plan. No worries, always have a backup plan. So Free Toast Host is a service specifically for Toastmaster clubs to host your own club website. It's free, and that's the first part. If it is free, you should have it. It allows you to create a website like this. This is one of my club websites, which I recently created as a preparation for this workshop, where you can showcase your club, list, for example, your club members, and they can showcase their bio data, their pictures, and you can explain what your club is all about, and also have an information about Toastmasters. What is Toastmasters all about? So the focus here is, when somebody is searching for Toastmasters, when somebody is searching for something to do in the local area and they find you, they have all the information to reach out to you to understand what they will get out of joining your club. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you using this Free Toast Host. Actually, the link is called Toastmasters Clubs. I will post it in the chat. So this is a service, and it is the good thing about this service, it is Toastmasters International approved, which means you can use it with confidence. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to create a website for one of my clubs which doesn't have a presence as of now, and that is the Trainers Toastmasters Club, 7011486. That's the club. And all I have to do to create a fresh website for this club is come to this link that I have just posted, scroll down and say, I want to request for a website. Just give your district number, your club number. It immediately identifies that this club, what is it, by going to the Toastmasters club directory and identifies. And this is very important. And one of the cool things about this website that I found is that the current XCOM can always take control of this website, regardless of who created it in the past, because it will always look for your contact information in the Toastmasters website. Very cool. So it finds it and says, KGB, actually, I am the contact here. I'll say that is correct. I'll give my name, my email ID. And this is the email ID, not of the Toastmaster contact, but who will act as the administrator of this website. And that's about it. To get a free website for your club, give your club number, give your district number, the name, make sure that you have access to that contact information, because it will send out a note to that club contact email that is listed and to your president if required, and submit a request. Now, all I have to do is go to my email address, and hopefully I would have received a link from FreeToastHost. This is the request coming to me, and it says, if you approve it, because this is the email in the Toastmasters club that it has sent it to that link, all I have to do is click approve, and my account is now approved. I have a website now. Go back to my email address. Maybe I'll receive one more saying that your website is set up. In 5 minutes, I have a free website, and the club number and the suffix toastmastersclubs.org is ready for me. I have a website. I can share this website with my club members. It is, of course, a default website. We have to start changing a couple of things in this, but we have a website. You might not like number.toastmasters because it's very difficult to remember, but we can fix it very easily. All I have to do now is click on login as site admin, agree to their policy, give the club number. Okay, so it will send a link to, again, an email address because I have not set up the password. It will come here and I can set the password for my website. Okay, so I'm now launched in as the website administrator. The first thing I will do is two things. I will change the website address to replace the number with a friendlier name. And secondly, I will change my password. So I launch this option saying launch admin console, then go to administrator info, and let me change my password here. Click save, and the password has been saved. So now I have an email address and a password to access this entire website. The first thing I would like to do is give a website alias. And when I say alias, instead of a number 70111486, let's call it trainers. And I hope there is no other club with the same name. Let's try it out. Done. I have now a website called trainerstoastmastersclubs.org. So what we would like to do is obviously, first of all, change the layout, customize it, put some content about our club instead of the default pictures that are there. And that is as simple as clicking on this button here, which says edit. Imagine this is like a Word document where you can put your information about your club. Let me change, for example, this image. I can simply delete it and I can click on this option somewhere here, which says image. I have an image, let's say on my computer, I can simply click on upload. Let's say this is one of the images from the trainers club, and then click send it to the server. I can browse the server and find that image that I have uploaded just now. So now suddenly I have a front page with a nice, of course I have to make it a better looking image, maybe all the club members or something like that, showcase one image showing all the trainers, and then I have a front page. In this section that you can see, I can type some details about my club. What do we do? I will not waste so much time creating all of this, but again, all I have to do is go to the admin console and go to the home page and type that information there. Remove this and start typing. A club helps you to become a confident public speaker. For example, start like that. If you want to make the text, let's say, big or bold, increase the size of the font, right? Italics, just like normal editing, change the color of the font, and so forth. Click save, and you are done. So now you have slowly started building your club page. The next thing you would like to let people who land upon your page, first of all, they'll see the images, they'll see the content, but how do we reach out to you? Click on the admin console, and we have all of these things that we can configure. We can configure our members, we can configure some extra web pages, we can have the appearance, we can change the color of the pages, all of these things that we can do. But right now, of course, we are looking for provide the meeting information to our visitors who are visiting our website. So if we were meeting in person, you would have given the directions of the club, the Google Map link, for example. But now, obviously, we can simply say we currently meet online using Zoom. And then what we can do is for every agenda that we post, and I will show you how to do that, you can put the Zoom ID so that people can directly join from the website, from Google search into your Zoom meeting. How cool is that? Now, any member who looks at this link, they will find that information. Of course, you can put a lot of information here on every link, and we can set up the Google map also. Currently, it is pointing to our physical location. And so that's how the website starts getting built up. Now we have created the website. We learn how to customize a homepage with our pictures, some content. And then there are this extra things. These are predefined templates, all pointing to Toastmasters. And it's a good idea to keep it. I don't see any reason why we should remove it. But if you don't want some of these panels, we can change them. We can go to the admin console and we can make changes to not show certain panels. For example, you can see by default, we have all of these panels, contact us, club calendar, meeting agenda, and so forth. So for example, you decide you don't want this panel, Toastmasters videos. You can click save and close. And then this panel from Toastmasters videos will disappear from this list. The next thing that you can do is you can provide additional pages. If you want to showcase certain things, you can create extra pages that will appear here. But the real power of this website, so there are two aspects to creating a website using FreeToastHost. The first is that you create a website that people can find whenever they are searching using Google or by clicking on the link that you provide. This website has rich tools to manage your club. And when I say to manage your club, what I am referring to is creating your agendas in advance, understanding who is going to attend this meeting, who signed up, what projects they have signed up. And all of this can be managed using the tools that are available here. Now, for me to go through those steps would take little time. So what I will do is I will show this to you from one of the websites that I have already created for my club, another club, Capital Speakers. And as you can see, and look at this website, Capital Speakers Toastmasters Club, I will log out as the site admin. This is a normal view of the website of the club. If a visitor comes, he can check, okay, what is this club all about? You'll get all the information that is available. Secondly, you can find out the meeting information as I showed you. There is a contact us form, also comes default. So guest or the visitor wants to send you a form saying, I'm interested, call me. So they can fill up their name and their phone number, and all of these people that I have marked here will get an email saying that this visitor needs more information, and any one of them can reach out to that guest. Also, those members who decide, okay, I don't mind showing my profile to the public. If you click on Meet Our Members, you will see that all the members will be listed along with their name, their club officer's role, a bio, and the links to every member's Facebook account, LinkedIn. So it's really a way for a guest or a visitor to find out who are these people, reach out to them to different channels, or just to reach out to them through the contact us form. Also, as a guest, he can check the club calendar and see that there are two meetings planned for this club, one on 14th, one on 28th. And again, if I had to create more pages, this is just a sample page I have created. I have created for here, you could create custom pages. You can put photos and text. So you can create additional custom pages. where you can showcase the achievements of your club, the awards that you have achieved. All of this could be showcased here. And also, if you want to have some downloads available to the members or to guests, you can have some PDF files or some documents uploaded, and that could be downloaded by visitors or members. And you can decide that this file that I'm uploading can be accessible by guest, this file that I'm uploading can be only accessed by members, or this file can be only accessed by XCOM team. So you can have that kind of permissions when you're creating this website. Now, the other interesting part is every member of your club can have a login to this website. So let me log in as a member now, not as an administrator, and see the magic that happens for members. I'm viewing this website as a member. The first thing I can do is I can look at the agendas that are already set up by the VP ad. I can see the meeting that was listed on 14th of August here. The agenda is ready for us. And I can see that the speaking slot number one has already been taken up by this dynamic member. And I can see that I can sign up for, if I want to give a speech, if I want to deliver an education segment. But in my case, I have already taken up the role as a speech evaluator. So all of the roles are available to you as an agenda. Members simply have to come sign up for that role or the speaking slot, and the role of a VP education is as simple as coming and checking, oh, everything is done, let me print the agenda. And we have different layouts available for us when we want to print. Let me use the FTH standard, and my agenda comes for me ready-made. I don't have to sit and make agendas. All I have to do is set up the agenda, how many speaking slots, or if there is an education segment, and let members sign up, and everyone sees in advance what is coming up for that meeting. For example, here I can see speaker one, as I said, has been taken up. She can choose, for example, the title of the speech. They can choose the path and the project. Everything is there in terms of the pathways catalog, the paths and the projects. What more do we want? This tool serves two purposes. First purpose, all of y'all should do it anyway. Create a presence for your club on the website. It takes 5 to 10 minutes maximum. Start customizing it. Start putting content about your club, the photos, the members, and the achievements, or the prospect will get if he joins our club. Put all of that information here. That's step number one. If you then want to go to step number two, that is to set up the whole agenda and so forth, I haven't shown you how to do it. I have only shown you how it works. But I do have a video on my YouTube channel. So I had created two videos to prepare for this workshop. One was how to set up a free Toastmasters club website. So that you have seen it. It's very simple. But how to use the Toastmasters club management tools. So if you want to understand how to set up your members, how to set up your agenda, go through that and see whether you can benefit from that additional features that are available to us in the club management tools. With that, I conclude my session today. Back to you, Master of Ceremony, Dr. Asharani.